Chef.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Waalaikumsalam. Okay, today we present about attitude management. But before the follow this slide, let's introduce our group. My name is Kurniaba Yudhoyono and my friend,
my name is Iqbal.
And so let's go slide for why. And okay, but first, let's get here. Attitude is a way of thinking and they shape how we relate to the world, both in work and outside of work. And then measuring them unobservable in order to predict behavior and to assess people respond to persuasion. And you all can see it here, attitude properties, evaluate strength. This strength is accessibility and reflexivity, and this other is cognitive function. Attitude is a system interfering with other systems. And not all attitudes are bad, equal attitudes can be self-defining potential measurement issues. And talk about attitude can change about time by time because the, like the, available. Your friends like change structure and structure is structure is like the questionnaire is like multiply answer equation and another and lots of structure is like you talk about your friends like and what do you like what do you mean like the other interactions like observe action observe behavior and judge human biases. This is AT, automatic evaluation or association. And physiological response is like personal attitude versus shared general attitude. Yes. Thanks. Okay, this structure versus structure is talked about before. A structure that's effective is like does not contradict people response, provide rights data, especially useful during the early stage of investigating of particular cases. So the effective structure, you can get the answer is too deep, but not really relevant. Like structure, advantage issue for respondent to answer, except for research to score focus ratio, you can specific properties of the attitude. You can, the money different is like the answer different than which others like the Iqbal or me, this the different answer. Thanks. So this about the cognitive component. It's three components. The first one is cognitive component. You can see it there, the cognitive functionalized component, blah 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 blah. Then maybe I think I give the example is like it's like when you see a baby, you in your mind it's like you trust the baby is cute or something like you happy to see the baby. Then you can see the thing here. This information includes awareness of the existence of the object, belief about the characteristic or attribute of the object. It's the characteristic is in yourself. And two, affective component. The affective or likely component provides a person's overall feeling toward object situation. This the thinking about the emotional the person is like example is like I had bread or something, but Iqbal love bread or something like this. I like chicken, but Iqbal not like chicken as like that. Thanks. So this intuition component, the intuition action component refers to person X, like with your behavioral object. In here, the behavioral component is centered on individual acting the accepted way towards something. It's like simple, it's like me and Iqbal, we have the different saying something. It's like saying the about the source. I like fans, but Iqbal like I IP or something. Okay, yes, my friend. Best friend can be defined as a recent process of assigning number of or other symbol to certain characteristic of the object of interest according to some perfect rules. Just mention about the best friend, but just other characteristics the person. This about the two characteristics of best friend. First one, there must be one-to-one correspondence between the symbol and the characteristic in the object is being measured. And two, the rules for estimate must be invariant over time and the object's being measured. And scaling is the process of creating a continuum on which objects are allocated according to the amount of the measured characteristic they possess. It's like scaling. Place, like the other place, the different scaling measurement. Okay, next by presentation by my friend Ivo.
Okay, I will continue the presentation. There are four type of measurement here, as you can see. The first one is nominal, interval, measure scale. Nominal scale objects are assigned to push both purely exclusive level category, but there are compository relatives among the category. So the number in nominal scale also work as an object of value. So the number do not have any mathematical means. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This do not have any correlation with the number in mathematics. So the number given, the purpose of the number will be just as a symbol for brown, black, blonde, gay, etc. Next one is ordinal scale. An ordinal scale is obtained when objects are ranked or arranged in order with regard to some common variable. It is the order of the value is not important and is significant, but the difference between each one is not really known. So the number here is kita bisa menurutkan nomor humoristik itu dari misalkan 1 itu very unhappy, 2 unhappy, 3 okay, 4 happy, and 5 very happy, but we cannot clearly see that the difference between here and here. We cannot know how many the difference between the very happy one and unhappy one. We do not exactly know something like that. Next is interval scale. In an interval scale, the number is the rank of the object also represent equal increments of the attribute being measured. So in interval scale, the differences between the numbers we can clearly know. Like, for example, we can know the difference between here to here and here to here. Yeah, like that. But this interval scale do not have absolute zero. What is absolute zero? When the scale goes to zero, it doesn't mean that there are no, for example, there are no temperature. Because in interval scale, when the scale goes to zero, it means that the temperature is still there. Because there are no such thing as no temperature. Next. And then it's the ratio scale. A ratio scale is a special type of interval scale that has an accurately defined 0 point. Example would include weight, mass, share, or dollar in saving account. With a ratio scale, it's possible to say how many times greater or smaller one object is than another. So it's like the previous scale, which is interval scale, but in ratio scale, we have 0 point. It's like when the example dollars in saving in our saving account is zero, it means we do not have any dollar at all, or it's like the example here is our weight, right? If we have zero weight, it means we do not have any weight at all. Yeah, that's it. The difference between ratio and interval. And then the next is types of input grading scales. There are two types in here, which is single and multiple. Single items are those that have only one item to measure a construct. So when the researchers listen to the market, to the consumer, they only ask a question to the respondent. There are seven types in here. The first one is itemized category scales. Example is when the researchers ask, what do you think about this product? They only ask that one question. The respondent then choose to answer, I'm satisfied, I'm not satisfied, and very unsatisfied. And next is comparison scale. It's like comparing to product. For example, it's like comparing how the service in hospital and in private clinic. The respondent has to answer that. Next is rank order scale. Rank order scale itu memberikan peringkat pada fitur produk berdasarkan kriteria tingkat kepentingan. Pada konsep baru berada kriteria kemauan responden membeli di masa mendatang. Lalu yang selanjutnya ada resource scaling. Responden diminta menyusun objek yang disediakan di tempat berdasarkan kesamaan. So, responden has to show their items to one category that has similar perception and preferences. Next is constant sum scale. This is the kind of question that I when you given a point and you need to allocate the 100 point. Misalkan dikasih 100 poin lalu kita harus memberikan alokasi itu pada masing-masing pertanyaan. Misalkan kita diberi 5 pertanyaan, kita diberi 5 pernyataan, lalu kita diberikan 100 poin. Nah, kita mengalokasikan 100 poin itu ke poin kerja pernyataan-pernyataan yang menurut kita itu paling berapa. Next is pictorial skills. Pictorial skills ini untuk kesadaran yang pada pengisiannya kita memperhitungkan gambar-gambar seperti apa bila kita puas kita memberi gambar senyum, kalau tidak puas memberi gambar pelan itu. The next is paired comparison scale. This is the multiple item scales in this museum. The researchers ask more than one question to the respondent. There are three types of multiple item measures. The first one is the score. So, satu skala yang dengan milik putih yang berbentuk skala interval. Buat dalam bentuk 40 sampai 50 pertanyaan yang relevan dengan variabel yang tidak dibuat. Oke, kedua itu ada Likert scale. Responden ini diminta untuk menjawab beberapa pertanyaan. Just like this example, the respondent has to answer the question, and they choose whether they agree, don't agree, or disagree like that. And the last one is semantic differential. This is the semantic differential scale example. there are five poems and there are each poem there are statements there. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.